there, Krista. What if I fall here? Somebody just bought these boots a couple minutes ago, so I just want to get them packaged up real quick and send them out USPS so they get to their new owner in the next 2 3 days. So I'm just going to share that real fast how I do this. I like to use a acid-free, dye-free paper when I'm wrapping things like this. I'll use this with shoes, with toys, a lot of times with clothes. I like to put it around pretty much anything that I'm sending out because if there is any contact with moisture while they're in transit, this will not allow for colors to transfer. It also makes a good stuffing for a little bit of padding, so it's kind of good for all sorts of different things. Something this size, one piece of it doesn't quite work to cover the whole thing, so I'm using two pieces per boot. So I'm just gonna get these in here and excuse the noise. I know the crinkly of like papers and plastics is really loud in the video, so I'll try not to talk while I'm touching that. Hopefully it's not too loud in the video. So that's boot one. And it's really simple to do this just to make sure that items are covered well and not having any issues with the transfer of color potentially. And then for things like this that we throw in, we always put a little thank you card. And with kiddos things, we always try to have something on hand, a little special thing to send. It's kind of tough with boys. I have found some really cool like foam paper airplane things to send along, but they don't make a lot of cool little trinkets for boys. But girls usually get little bracelets from us, or sometimes necklaces. It depends on what we find for cool little things like that that are lightweight and not going to add a whole lot to the weight of the package. So that's going to go in there too. So it's just a nice little touch I feel to have in there. So we're going to get the box in these boots. Not the original box of the boots because that was somehow lost in time. I find that with a lot of the boot boxes, if you put them in lengthwise to lengthwise, kind of matching up with a poly bag, they fit nicely. And in our listings, we do specify that we're going to use a poly bag around the shoe box or another box if we don't have a shoe box that they fit in. And we do offer the option to increase the price of the item just a little bit to help cover the cost if they want it, the box in a box. But we find that they ship just fine in a shoebox, in a poly bag, and it also allows for the shipping price to be a little bit cheaper. So, you know, kind of good all around. It's good for everybody. So, anyway, get this finished up here. Get that taped. And then, so I'm weird. I don't really like the kind of loose ends, so after I'm done with the video, I'll take this over and kind of tape this down because I don't like the kind of loose floppy pieces. I don't know, probably just my OCD, but I'm weird like that. So that's the package. I'll put the label on it elsewhere too because you don't need to see anybody's address. So bye for now. Take care.